Welcome. In this video, I'll be answering these questions based on the break-even chart. The first five questions require identifying the lines and regions represented by the letters A to E. The line A here has to be the fixed cost as it remains unchanged irrespective of the number of units. Line B starts at fixed cost and increases gradually with increasing number of units. In essence, it will have its lowest value when units is zero, and that lowest value corresponds to the fixed cost. Therefore, B is the total cost. Line C has a value of zero when units is zero and increases in proportion to units afterwards. Recall that total revenue is zero when zero units are sold and then increases in proportion to units of output. Line C therefore must be the total revenue line. In region D here, total cost is greater than total revenue. So this region represents loss. And in E, total revenue is greater than total cost. So E represents profit. For part F, the break-even volume in units can be found by tracing the intersection of the total revenue function and total cost function down to the unit axis here. Note that the midpoint of 120 and 160 here is 140. That is, 120 plus 160 divided by 2. So the midpoint of 140 and 160 will be 150. That is, the break-even point in units is 150. For break-even in dollars, we trace the intersection of total revenue and total cost to the dollar axis. Note that each unit on the vertical axis here is $2,000. Therefore, break-even dollars point is the midpoint of $8,000 and $10,000. Adding them and dividing by 2 gives $9,000. In H, we want the total revenue at 300 units. That is, the midpoint of 280 and 320 here. Tracing that to the total revenue line will correspond to the midpoint of 16,000 and 20,000 here, which is 18,000. For I, we need the fixed cost at 218 units. Since the fixed cost is the same for any number of units, it will remain at 6,000. For J, we need the profit or loss at 400 units. So we take the total revenue there, which is 24,000, and subtract the total cost there, which is 14,000 from it, and that gives 10,000. For K, we want the total variable cost at 200 units. Recall that total cost equals fixed cost plus total variable cost. Thus, we can find the total variable cost by subtracting the fixed cost from total cost. Total cost at 200 units is $10,000, and the fixed cost is $6,000. Therefore, the total variable cost is $10,000 minus $6,000, and that gives $4,000. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.